الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على شرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Now, as we did the last hadith, which was, I think it's from Sahih Muslim, I thought that I will do one more hadith just to strengthen our grammar knowledge that we studied in the last session. So this hadith is common, which is being viral and it's being spread due to the coronavirus. And it goes something like this. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika minal barasi wal jununi wal juzami wa minas sayyil asqami. So the hadith is from Sunan Abu Dawood, and I think it is number 1544, if I mistake not. So let's see how this hadith goes as far as the grammatical analysis goes. So the first word is Allahumma, and I already indicated in the last video that Allahumma is a way to call Allah emphatically. So you are saying, oh Allah, basically. Then the next word is Inni. So by now it should be very clear that Inni is harf of nasb and its victim. Inni is inna plus ni. So it basically translates as indeed I. Then the next word is a verb, it's a fail. So now it should be clear. Last time we had not studied the fail, but this time it should be a little bit clearer. It says a'uzu. So the family of the verb is aza ya'uzu. Aza is a past tense, ya'uzu is a present tense. Now if ya'uzu is a present tense, ya'uzu means he seeks refuge. This is a'uzu, which means this pertains to I. I already indicated that ya'uzu, the thing, the first word of the table, present tense table, is he. Then you can directly convert to I by changing ya to a or hamza. And if you want to change it to we, you can change it to na. So if instead of a'uzu, if this dua was na'uzu, then it would mean indeed we seek refuge. But this one says a'uzu, so this is a personal dua. Personal, individual is making a dua that indeed I seek refuge. Seek refuge in what? Bika. A'uzu bika. B means with, ka means you, or B means in, or ka means you. So I seek refuge in you. Okay, fine. You seek refuge in me. Allah says you seek refuge in me. Then from what? It goes on to say minal barasi. Minal barasi. Now min, harf of jar. That's why your word al-barasu has changed to al-barasi. Now what does this al-barasi means? This al-barasi, this relates to the disease of leprosy, which is caused by the bacteria Mycobacterium leprae. And that's why the person who gets affected is called as leper. Basically, this is a disease that affects the skin and the nerves. So I seek, we are calling to Allah and asking that I seek refuge in you from the leprosy disease. Okay, and what? Wal jununi. Junoon. Now in Urdu, it has a little bit of different slang meaning. Junoon means josh or kind of a positive connotation to it. But junoon means madness, pagalpan, divanapan. That's why you have this word that majnoon comes from junoon. Majnoon means that which is affected by junoon, which is mad, a mad person. So I seek refuge from the jununi also. Now jununi is also jar. That's because it is an implied min. Minal barasi, minal jununi. And then it goes on to say wal juzami. Now wal juzami, this comes from the word jazama. Jazama linguistically means to cut off something, to shed off, to remove. So especially this is related to body part. If a body part is removed, like a hand is cut off, the arm is cut off, or even when you remove the tonsil or appendix, it still means jazama. So jazama means basically to cut off or to do away with the body part. So we seek refuge. It is also used for the leprosy. Also it is used. The one who gets affected by jazam is called as majzoom. Majzoom means leper. A person who is leper. Then it goes on to say, wamin sayyil asqami. Wamin sayyil asqami. Now before that, this juzami word is also used in some of the translations. It says the disease of elephantiasis, which is a disease where the person's some body parts or muscles of some body parts get swollen up. means the person is usually like his hand and his hand is of this size, but the foot becomes of this size, or his neck becomes of this big. So some of the body parts are abnormally swollen. That is an elephantiasis disease, which is caused because of the parasitic worm infections. So some of the translations say that juzami refers to that, but linguistically it refers to leper. Okay, then it goes on to say wamin sayil askami. Wamin sayil askami, and from the say means evil, that which is bad. Sayil askami. Askami, this comes from the word sakam, sakama. Sakama means illness or weakness or leanness or skinniness, which there is no flesh, he's very very lean, very, very thick. Because of some disease, a person gets too much thin. That is called as sakama. And this sakama is a singular word. The plural would be askam. It's like faal, afal. So askam is the plural of sakama. Sakama means illness. So from the illness, or from the evil of all the illness. So basically the whole translation goes, O Allah, I seek refuge in you from the leprosy, disease of leprosy, from the madness, and from the jazami, which is elephantiasis, or again leprosy, and from the evil of any kind of illness or weakness. I hope that benefits. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum.